going on, YouTube fam? It's your boy Tony Two Times, and we back with another episode of Hood Tales, man. Before I start, be sure to like, comment, share, and definitely watch the video to the end. Let's get right into it. Portland, Oregon. When you think of Oregon, you probably think of high mountains and pretty landscape. But just like any other city in America, Portland has its hoods and gangs. In this episode of Hood Tales, we will be discussing the Portland Hoover Criminals Gang. The Hoovers, which back in the day was actually a Crip set, but eventually branched off from Hoover Crips to just Hoover or Hoover Criminals. Allegedly, the gang originated in Cali, but eventually set up shop in Oregon in the 80s and 90s and gave them the gang in which they ran with. The Hoover Criminals in Portland were said to have a stronghold in the city for over 30 years before the feds would get on them. Let's talk about some alleged events of the gang. The Hoovers were said to be involved in drug trafficking, hits, assaults, and robberies, and had bases in Oregon, Cali, and Washington State. One man who was said to be an OG of the Portland Hoovers, who nicknamed was OG Lowdown, was said to have two bodies and almost a 30-year run in the streets, which goes back to the 90s. On one situation, Lowdown, back on July 19th, 1998, was with a group of men when a fight broke out with a Latino gang at the El Moro Apartments on 2016 Southeast 122nd Avenue. Hours after the fight, a 27-year-old Latino man was unfortunately shot and killed. But at the time, with no witnesses and evidence, the case would go cold. Fast forward, the Hoovers grew stronger in Portland, having two fractions, the Hoover 107 and the 7-4 Hoovers. With a reputation of getting money and holding each other down, numbers grew, with initiation either being jumped in or sliding on the ops for the gang. With other gangs also growing in the area, the Hoovers really became Renegade, or ABK, meaning anybody killer, whoever went against them. On another incident, allegedly Lowdown was charged with the hit of a 27-year-old man, two blocks from Cleveland High School. Portland police responded to shots fired on the 3600 block of 28th Avenue at 1:41 a.m. September 17, 2017 to find a man shot when ambulance rushed him to the hospital, but unfortunately he didn't make it and lost his life. Allegedly, the Portland streets pointed at the Hoover OG Lowdown and another man that was an Englewood family blood member. After Lowdown was caught with a Glock 40 with ballistics matching to the death of the young man. But the case was deeper than that. On another incident, three Hoovers were out looking for ops or anybody allied against them, when a young man who was walking home from his first job was spotted outside of a store, shots was fired, hitting him. He was stumbling to forcibly die at the front door of Plaid Patriot on Southeast Division and 112th Avenue. More situations happened. When a blood member and a Hoover would get into a fight at a nightclub, the Hoover member would eventually hit the op, leaving him dead on the scene, which started a war between the Hoover criminals and bloods in the area. With police in the area knowing the gang colors, tattoos, and even having a copy of their rules and knowledge called Groove Scriptures, the investigation allegedly started all the way back in the 90s, with the younger members in the 2000s going on missions to show the OGs they were witty, that would lead to the Hoovers beefing with different sets, including the Crips, Kirby Black Crips, Columbia Villa Crips, and the Rolling 60s. A RICO indictment would come down on the gang, accusing OG Lowdown of two hits, the 1998 murder after the fight, which was a cold case, and the hit of the young man in 2017 by the school. Other members was arrested as well, accused of hits, robberies, drug trafficking, firearms possession, and more. One member told police, "This gives a bad name to the Hoovers, because I know for a fact it's more Hoovers working and taking care of their families than active in the streets." Portland police allege it's been 30 years of investigation, and they know the gangs ins and outs. Accusing members of reckless shootings of homes, raising the crime rate in the city, and recruiting younger guys just to shoot. In the head of the young man coming from work, a few members received life in prison. OG Lowdown, who was 46 years old at the time of indictment, faces two bodies and a RICO case. in which police dropped one body to focus on the Noah case. More members have been charged over the years after a few alleged drive-bys and witness intimidation, in which some members feel like other Hoovers helped in the investigation. The streets is the streets all over the world. I know to some people being an OG is power and having a long run in the streets, but when should a person give it up? 46 years old is not too old, but old enough not to be running the streets, in my opinion. If you haven't made it out by then, chances of you getting jammed up or getting hit is big. Moral of this story, murder has no statute of limitation. And after 30 years in the streets, if you are still free and alive, count your blessings and figure out something else. Times change and the game changes. So remember, we gotta succeed, not to fail. So we won't be just another hood tale. Man, crazy story, you feel me? Like, I was kind of surprised because I didn't even know that Oregon was rocking like that. I ain't even gonna sit here and hold y'all. Like, when you think of Portland, like I said, you think of mountains and landscape, but I never sleep on cities just because I never heard of them or just because they don't got a lot going on, because everybody in their individual way got a lot going on. And as y'all can see, they was pretty active. But my thing is, 30 years, like, that's a long investigation. You feel me? Like, that's crazy that the police knew all this information and was watching the organization for 30 years. And really, mainly, the OG Lowdown. You feel me? Like, I think after the man got hit at the apartments after the fight, they kind of already knew he did it. But back in the 90s, technology wasn't as good. So they really couldn't pin it on him because they didn't have no witnesses or no evidence. You know what I mean? But then in 2017, when he allegedly hit the dude up by the school, I feel like either they had somebody talking, or once they caught him with the blicky, they had him for that body, but somebody had to get him information on the previous body from 1998. But like I said, man, murder ain't got no statute of limitations. So you feel me? You can get away with it for 30, 40 years. But if new evidence come out, they could definitely come snatch you up. But yeah, these dudes got big time, man, you feel me? And it's a lot of information about the Portland, Oregon Hoovers, you feel me, that I ain't even get into, man, you know what I mean? And the Bloods up there. But we'll cover that on another episode of Hood Tales. Y'all already know, this your boy Tony Two Times. Be sure to like, comment, share. I love y'all, fam. I'm out.